और बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। इन यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी स्टार्टेड आर्मा एंड अरीमा व्हिच इज इन फैक्ट एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द ऑटो कोरिलेशन। इफ सम ऑफ यू वर वर्किंग इन द लैब ऑन दिस टॉपिक, द टॉपिक ऑफ ऑटो कोरिलेशन, एंड देन डायरेक्टली वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड्स आर्मा एंड अरीमा, it will further strengthen the concepts. Now in ARMA and ARIMA, theoretically we have already discussed, they are basically the forecasting methods. And forecasting is at most important in finance. Even in accounting, it is very important. But unfortunately, pure in accounting field, people do not pay attention to the forecasting and they follow typical methods to forecast the future value. That is why the decisions taken by the accountant are generally misleading. Their forecasting is, it can be correct up to say 70-75%, but the financial analysts generally are in search of forecasting, which is relatively more reliable and trustworthy. And ARMA and ARIMA models, in fact, fulfill the requirement and the condition. So ARMA and ARIMA basically follows Box-Jenkins. That is why the heading here is Box-Jenkins steps. In yesterday's lecture, we studied the theory and then we estimated one or two models. In today's lecture, this is lab lecture. Therefore, the steps of the Box-Jenkins have been clearly identified and they have been well organized. You can see on the screen, basically four major steps are there. Number one, identification. Number two, estimation. And then after the estimation, applying the diagnostic test. And after the application of the diagnostic test, when the model fulfills all the requirements of a good model, then we can use it for the purpose of forecasting. And then within these four major steps, small or sub steps or sub measures are also listed. For example, when we talk about the identification, just to recall before we start identification and then estimation and so on, just to recall what we have done theoretically in the previous lecture, in yesterday's lecture, ARMA and ARIMA, they are basically forecasting methods. So the forecasting is based on the information available within the series. So using the forecasting within the series, basically this follows the theory in finance, the theory of, you are familiar with the efficient market hypothesis. So basically it follows the efficient market hypothesis, wherein there are, you know, three different approaches. And the dominating approach is that the information within the price fluctuation is very, very important, and that needs to be got and to be used for the purpose of forecasting or taking efficient decisions. So ye iske piche theory hai. And the econometric technique are the econometric methods of ARMA and ARIMA, and particularly the Box-Jenkins methods, are closely related or linked with these efficiency market hypothesis. So isme, and the beauty of this model is you do not need many variables, just one variable. The variable itself, the financial time series itself, is sufficient. Only historical data is needed. And this historical data, since intuitively carries a lot of information within it. So in itself, the information which is intuitively available can be used for the purpose of forecasting based on certain steps and measures which have to be followed. So the philosophy of ARMA or ARIMA in general, the philosophy of econometrics is how far we are successful in making the data speak itself. So we try to make the data speak out about itself. And ARMA and ARIMA are generally very useful for the investors who are planning to enhance their investment if they have undertaken investment somewhere. And they can take prudent decisions if they understand how to forecast the possible or prospective returns from an investment. And it is also useful, ARMA and ARIMA models are also useful for the policymakers. How they are useful for the policymakers? If the macroeconomic variables or the information associated with any financial or economic time series is leading the system in the wrong direction, then corrective measures can be taken. For example, when stock market is going up unnecessarily, or when it is dropping, or it is indicating the bearish trend all the time, and the indexes are falling and falling, and then suddenly they start rising. So this is a thing to worry about. This actually indicates that many people, many investors benefit from this situation. They make a lot of money through capital gains. But this situation is uncertain because capital market is associated with the money market, and money market is linked with the macroeconomic variables or the indicators. For example, in investment decisions are based on the interest rate followed by the financial institutions or central bank of the country. So if the volume of investment is increasing, so definitely the stock market is affected or it takes the message. And investment can only be expanded when the economic activities are good, when economic cycles, business cycles are in good direction and good dimension. When economic activities are on boom, the stock market is also likely to show good performance. But good performance does not mean all the time that there is increasing index. Sometimes this increasing index or decreasing index is also due to these speculative activities. For example, these days, the dollar price is falling. So rupee seems to have been strengthened. So how this has happened? Actually, international market scenario, the international market conditions, general elections in US, and then US-China trade relationship, trade war, and European Union trade relationship with US, and then rising Asian economies. So if you look at the scenario and you draw the trend lines of dollar against Asian economies, currencies, you will see against almost all the Asian currencies, dollar has weakened significantly. But as far as Pakistan is concerned, it is falling very gradually. Very gradual. So this gradual decline, if we draw the parallelogram, which we were discussing yesterday and today also we'll be using the parallelogram. So that actually indicates very slow, very gradual decline or decay in spikes of the parallelogram as far as Pakistani rupee is concerned. So this method is closely linked with the financial analysis. So that is why the students should pay attention to this method, because they will be using this method if they are joining some professionally strong organizations which deal in financial analysis. So ye unke liye bahut useful hoga, even if they wish to launch their own profession, or for they go for the self-employment in capital market or in some other say money market or foreign exchange market. So these methods are useful. So generally people who are engaged in such activities, for example currency, stock market, they use very specialized software, and within the software the programming actually incorporates the autoregressive method and the moving average, more dominantly moving average methods. The moving average method ke apni limitations hain, because that captures only the stochastic factor, but most of the information is generally associated with the lagged value of the stock price or the major financial time series which is under discussion. But the moving average actually ignores the lag value of the dependent variable, the actual variable itself, the target variable itself. So ARM and ARIMA, lekin usme unke software mein ye options bilkul maujood hoti hain ARM ARIMA ki, but most of the analysts are unable, or they are not capable of using ARM and ARIMA, or even there are some better method than ARM and ARIMA, so they are unable to use it and they mostly focus on the moving average. तो ये इसका थोड़ा सा बैकग्राउंड है. अब बॉक्स जेंकिंस क्या है? बॉक्स एंड जेंकिंस, दीज टू फाइनेंशियल एनालिस्ट और इकोनॉमेटिशियन, दे हैव एक्चुअली डिजाइंड, दे हैव लिस्टेड सर्टेन स्टेप्स, एंड आई हैव समड अप दीज स्टेप्स इनटू फोर कैटेगरीज. फर्स्ट कैटेगरी इज ऑफ आइडेंटिफिकेशन, सेकेंड इज एस्टिमेशन, डायग्नोस्टिक टेस्टिंग, थ्री एंड देन इन द एंड फोरकास्टिंग. Starting with the identification, I have organized the yesterday's discussion because we will be following these methods, so they should be well organized before you practically start estimating ARMA and ARIMA. So the first step is plot and preview, or plot or preview. It should be plot/preview, and then look at the correlogram, the second step, and from the correlogram see whether the financial time series is stationary or non-stationary. When we say non-stationary, so non-stationary means when the spikes are decaying or decreasing or falling very slowly. There is very gradual decline in spikes, that indicates non-stationarity. Non-stationarity means mean and the variances do not remain constant over time. Constant means they are rounding off, exactly same, not the same, not exactly the same for every time, but more or less they move around certain constant mean. And if we take mean of the mean, grand mean, the fluctuation of mean should be around the grand mean. इसी तरह ये non-stationary. So if it is non-stationary, then ARIMA, ARMA can be employed. Otherwise, we can use simple regression. Obviously, when it is non-stationary, there is very significant presence of autocorrelation. The current value of the financial series is taking impact from its one period lag or two period lag or lagged values in general. So when it is non-stationary, then we can stationarize it by taking either the first difference. All this is in the identification. Either we can take the first difference or we can apply differential law. Now, when and how we decide whether we should apply the first difference or we should take a differential log. Again, we have done it multiple times. When you plot a series, you have to look at the outliers. The differential log directly controls the presence of outliers. So outliers are immediately damped when we apply log, and then we take the difference, first difference. तो फर्स्ट डिफरेंस लेने के बाद जब हम इसको फिर रीचेक करते हैं नाउ द स्पाइक्स ऑफ द कोरेलोग्राम दे श्रिंक इनटू रीजनेबल डिस्टेंस नाउ वी काउंट द स्पाइक्स अगेन एंड दिस काउंटिंग ऑफ स्पाइक्स इन दिस काउंटिंग ऑफ स्पाइक्स वी लुक एट द ACF spikes and PACF spikes. The order of ARIMA is generally written as PDQ. D is for the difference which we have taken, whether it is differential log or whether it is simple D or first difference. I hope all of you know how to get first difference. The period t value minus period t minus 1 value is known as the first difference. तो ARMA का जो order है actually when we say identification तो identification में the target is in fact number one plotting and seeing whether the series qualifies for ARIMA. The fluctuation will determine it. And then the stationarity check from the stationarity check and then taking the first difference, we can identify the value of P and Q. The first difference is taken once only, therefore D is 1. But if we are not taking first difference, then it will be just PQ, P0Q, when we are not taking the difference. So when we are taking the difference, then it becomes ARIMA. So this is not ARMA, it should be written as ARIMA. If in the presence of first difference, we are trying to find out P and Q. So short isko hum karenge, to cut the long story short, we can say identification means identification of order of ARIMA. And how to determine the order of ARIMA? If we count the spikes and their distance from PACF, this will give us the value of P. P se yaad rakhein, P, P. PACF spikes will determine the number of P's, the value of P. And the number of spikes coming out of the confidence interval, coming out of the boundaries, जो वो जो है upper and lower bounds हैं, जो dotted lines हैं, उससे बाहर आ रही हैं, so those terms are counted as Q. So after having identified the number of P, D, and Q, then we make multiple models for the purpose of estimation. And then we move on to the next step, estimation. For example, if from the identification process, we have identified the value of P equal to 1 and 12, what does that mean? The first spike and the 12th spike of PACF is coming out of the boundaries, the lower bound and the upper bound. And Q is 1 and 12 means the first and the 12th spike of ACF is coming out of the lower and the upper bound. So the possible combinations, the possible models which we can identify and then estimate or we can estimate R. This is one possibility because there are two values of P1 and 12, Q1 and 12. So 1-1 combination, 1-12 combination, 12-1 combination, 12-12 combination. So possibly four models, 1, 2, 3, 4 models will be estimated in this case. So first ARIMA 1-1-12 means P value 1, taking the first difference of the series, and Q value 12. And in eViews, we will follow this step if we are using command window. So in the command window, we will write the method and then difference of the series, oil price series. And P value is 1, therefore AR1. Q value is 12, therefore we will write MA12. इनकी थ्योरी हम वैसे पढ़ चुके हैं मैं आई विल आल्सो शो यू इन द एंड आई हैव रिकॉर्डेड इट हियर सो सेकंड मॉडल 111 सिमिलरली थर्ड मॉडल 12 1 12 बट 1 ऑल द टाइम बिकॉज वी हैव अप्लाइड द फर्स्ट डिफरेंस देयरफॉर 1 इन द मिडल विल बी इन ऑल द मॉडल इट विल अपीयर इन ऑल द मॉडल्स तो अरीमा 12 1 1, so we will be estimating this model. This is as far as estimation is concerned. After the estimation, we apply certain diagnostic tests. First I will explain the theory, then I will show you the process using the actual data. So diagnostic test mein kya karte hain, after having estimated all these four possible models, we see, suppose, now what are the guidelines before we go for the diagnostic test? In the estimation process, what are the guidelines? The guidelines are that you should start with the longer lag and then reduce it to a few lags. How will you reduce it? How will you start with the longer lag? Longer lag means, suppose the spikes, if you drag and go through the parallelogram, some distant lags are also appearing. जैसे 12 है, तो 12 के बाद भी कोई है, तो इसलिए हम उसको ज्यादा से स्टार्ट करते हैं. या जैसे हम यहाँ पे मैंने AR1 लिखा है, तो हम AR2, AR3, इसी तरह MA12 है, तो MA10, 11, 12, इसको कहते हैं लॉन्गर लैग. तो गाइडलाइंस आर दैट यू शुड स्टार्ट विद लॉन्गर लैग एंड देन लुकिंग एट द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ देयर कॉफिशिएंट्स, ड्रॉपिंग देम द इनसिग्निफिकेंट कॉफिशिएंट्स और AR एंड MA टर्म्स री एस्टिमेट. फिर देखें कौन सा कोई इन उसमें से इनसिग्निफिकेंट है, देन ड्रॉपिंग द इनसिग्निफिकेंट order and then re-estimating for the lower order. अच्छा, इसमें अगर आप इसको समझें, this is known as parsimonious method. लिख देता हूं ताकि आपके notes में आ जाए. parsimonious नहीं, मेरा ख्याल है I के साथ है. Let's check it. यस, आई के साथ पार्सिमोनियस मेथड. तो ये रिक्वायरमेंट है इसकी बॉक्स एंड जेंकिंस टेक्निक की, कि व्हाई टू स्टार्ट विद द लॉन्गर लैग एंड देन रिड्यूस इट टू स्मॉलर लैग. इसका मतलब क्या पार्सिमोनियस? पार्सिमोनियस मींस एस्टिमेट द मॉडल विद मिनिमम लॉस ऑफ डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम. तो मिनिमम लॉस ऑफ डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम विल बी व्हेन यू आर एस्टिमेटिंग द मॉडल विद मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ कोफिशिएंट्स, यानी मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ लैग्स. पॉसिबली जबरदस्ती नहीं हम उसको रिड्यूस कर सकते. सो वी विल एस्टिमेट सो फार एज द कोफिशिएंट्स ऑफ द लैग आफ्टर द एस्टिमेशन आर they become significant. So if they are not significant, we can drop the the insignificant terms. So this is known as parsimonious method. This parsimonious method say we come up with a certain model, we estimate it again, the finalized method, the finalized model, and estimate and check the PAC, PACF and ACF for the error terms, mu. ये कहाँ से होता है? When we have estimated the model, we can plot the error terms of, we can view the graph of the error term or the mu. Mu of the estimated ARIMA model. जी, break कर लें.
सर मेरा, जी सर break कर लें, फिर नया session start कर लेते हैं.
चलें, we will start with the diagnostic test.
Okay जी, ये ही link, same link आप लोग दोबारा ये end होने के बाद join कर सकते हैं. Thank you.